G'day guys, it's Billy here from losttreasure.com.au. Well fellas, I'm going to do a very simple and very healthy dish tonight. A lot of you people might know about it, especially English, Australian and New Zealanders. This dish is called Bubble and Squeak and it's very, very simple to make. It's very, very healthy and anyone can make it. Even a six-year-old child can make this dish, fellas. So what we've got here is the ingredients, and we'll just quickly show you. We'll start over here. So the first thing, so what we've got here is some nice garlic, some cabbage, just over here some Greek feta cheese, some Dutch Edam cheese, over here bacon always goes really nice with Bubble and Squeak. We've got some diced onion there as well. Just here, some beautiful pumpkin, some beans, potato, and some tomato. So the easiest way to make this, fellas, is by using leftover food, okay? So in the last few nights I've been eating pumpkin, potato, beans, and tuna, and also some nice Greek salad. So as you can see here, the pumpkin, the beans, and the potato is already cooked. So that's the main purpose for making Bubble and Squeak. We use the leftover food from the previous night's dishes or the previous day's dishes. So as I say, the pumpkin's cooked, beans, potato, and that's it. Just in regards to making Bubble and Squeak, fellas, just by looking at these ingredients, it doesn't mean you have to use these exact ingredients. You can use anything you like. So such examples are red or green capsicum, or as they call it in the United States, red or green pepper. You can use chili, chopped chili. You can use cauliflower. You can also use broccoli. So I've just cooked this fresh broccoli. And you can use diced cherry tomatoes. You can also use eggs. You can use celery. So basically it's up to you. Whatever you think would go nice in a Bubble and Squeak, you just use your imagination. And as I say, it's so very, very easy and it's absolutely delicious. It's very, very famous in Australia and the UK. A lot of people have it for breakfast, but tonight I'm having it for dinner. So I'm looking forward to this, guys. I've had a long couple of days. It's just gone 10 past 10 in the evening. This is about the average time I eat. So anyway, we'll get started and we'll show you exactly what I'm going to add step by step. And just here, fellas, if you can get yourself a nice iron, cast iron cooking pan like this, they're excellent for cooking on gas fire, electric stoves, and so forth. You can also cook the Bubble and Squeak and then place the cast iron pan inside an oven at approximately anywhere between 150 and 180 degrees Celsius. As you can see here, fellas, one RTB Kapuka. That tea towel there is 23 years old. I got that for my mum for a present when I first joined the army. It's the first recruit training battalion in Kapuka. I joined the army in 1989, so a lot of good memories and a lot of bad memories as well, because it was hard work, guys, but it was the best thing I ever did. And guess what I did in the army? I was a cook. I was a cook in the army for about 7 years, and it was the best thing I ever did. Never ever regret it, guys. I'm a single bloke and I can cook really nice foods. I always try and eat healthy. During the day I don't eat the best, but I do eat heaps of fruit during the day. I don't really sit down and have a proper lunch. Never eat breakfast. Anyway, we'll get going. We'll turn the stove on now and we're gonna turn it on high and wait until that starts to smoke a little tiny bit, and then we'll chuck some olive oil in it and the garlic and we'll get started. And as we're always told in the army, guys, prior preparation prevents piss poor performance, or the French word for preparing food. I I think you pronounce it mise en place or something like that. But anyway, guys, if you're going to cook a decent meal, make sure you always prepare. As you can see, I've got everything laid out properly. There's nothing worse than, like, for example, cooking garlic. Then you've got to go and chop up the cabbage. The garlic gets burnt. You know, the bacon gets burnt, so forth. So always make sure that you're prepared. And I'm pretty clean, guys. I hate dirty stoves. I always make sure that my stove and kitchen's always clean. All right, that started to smoke. So we're just going to put some olive oil in there, like that. I'm going to chuck that garlic in. So I'm just going to cook that garlic, guys. The last thing you want to do is burn it. I'm going to have to turn this camera off in a minute. That's really, really hot. It's already starting to burn a little bit. And I'm going to chuck in the bacon and onion. Anyway, guys, I can't do this one-handed. We're just going to cook that bacon. There's a pumpkin, a little bit of pumpkin potato in there, but that's all right. We're just going to make this bacon, brown it off, mix it up with the garlic. Mmm, this is absolutely beautiful dish, guys. Well, it's beautiful. Just grab that piece of bacon that just dropped. I'm going to put this phone down again in a minute. I'm using a Samsung Galaxy to film this, guys. So always garlic first, guys. Brown off the garlic, don't burn it. Then we add in the bacon and diced onion. And this is a beautiful dish for even camping. We'll cook this over a fire. Just browning that off, guys. Not stressing out. Try not to panic. Take your time and relax. Always nice and relaxing when you're cooking a nice meal. I was actually on TV once as a cook in the army, guys. We got filmed by a proper one of the first original cooking shows in Australia. I forget the name of the, What's Cooking as it's called, and that guy's name was Jeff. I forget his last name, but he's still around, and he came to the film just. I was on TV, you saw me taking a roast chuck out of the oven. And if you're on TV, sorry, and if you're in Australia, I was also on Hinch, believe it or not, when I was at Kapuka. They were doing a TV show about one of the physical training instructors. It was a female. She was nice looking, guys, but far out, she was rough as guts. But they had to be back in those days. We got treated like crap sometimes. If we didn't do anything right, we'd be doing 50 bloody chin-ups. Alright, so that's right now, guys. We're just going to chuck in a little bit of cabbage. I won't chuck it all in yet. I've just got to... Also, soya sauce would be nice. You could add soya sauce to this. Give it a bit more flavour, a little bit of salty flavour. Soya sauce always goes really nice with cabbage. Also add meat, other types of meat to this, guys. Roast pork, steak to spice it up or make it into little strips. So I'm going to do something different in a minute, guys. I'll show you what I'm going to do. I'm just going to add a little bit of water to that in a minute, just so that cabbage can steam and cook. It smells nice. Well, as we say in Australia, it smells nice. Because I remember once when I was cooking in Amsterdam, one of the young cooks showed me a dish and I said, oh, that smells nice. And he said, nice? What's nice? And I had to try and pronounce nice properly so he understood what I meant. Or as I say in Holland, that's lekker. De partij met jou, how are you? Ik hou van jou, Esther. Ik mis jou. That's my beautiful ex-Dutch girlfriend I was with for about 7 years, man. She was the best girl I ever met. 7 years, mate. 7 years, she changed my life, I can tell you that. She taught me so much, photography. She taught me how to, you know, respect so much art, architecture. You know, when you're walking down a street, don't look down, look up, and you can see all the beautiful architecture. And that same thing goes for if you live in Australia. When you're walking down a local street, even in rural Australia, you look up and you see all the beautiful old architecture up the top of the, just below the roofs. Alright, so that's not really, really nice. I don't usually whip stuff out like that, guys, but I'm just trying to do this video properly. Alright, now, I'm going to chuck that in there, the potatoes, beans, and the pumpkin. So that's it, guys, we're just about finished, but like I say, you can add just about anything you like. Cauliflower, I've got the cauliflower or the broccoli just behind me. And like I say, this is a beautiful, nice, healthy dish. Beautiful breakfast dish. You can have this anytime, breakfast, lunch, dinner, or as we say in Australia, tea, breakfast, brekkie. I'm just going to turn that slide down a little bit, guys. Let's just slide down a little bit. What I'm going to do now is just put a little tiny bit of water. Alright, guys, I've probably got about a quarter of a cup of water there, but just use your imagination. Just steam that. You can always also cover that. You can cover the actual pan to let it steam properly, but it's pretty hot at the moment, so we don't really need to do that. And we're just going to let that water simmer and reduce down, and that cabbage will be cooked in a couple of minutes. As you can see, it already looks nice. Just want to let that simmer a little bit, and then after that, guys, we'll chuck in the cauliflower and then the cheese. Okay, that's cooking really nice, guys, but as I say, I hate mess. It's nothing worse than a dirty stove. I blame that on my military training. But it's a good thing to have a nice clean kitchen, but I'm not going to show you my kitchen because it's not really clean. I need new vinyl. This floor is shocking. I ripped up the vinyl. It's awful, embarrassing. I hate it. And that's why I've got these tea towels here too, just connect bloody grease. I hate it. It's looking really nice. It's nearly cooked. That broccoli there is actually half cooked, so I wouldn't recommend chucking in raw broccoli. Just make sure you cook it. Just makes it, if you chuck in raw broccoli or cauliflower, the actual rest of the ingredients are going to burn. So I'm just going to chuck in the tomato or tomato. We'll just let that cook a little bit, guys. And we'll come back in a minute. Okay, we're just about there. So what I'm going to do now, I've just turned the stove on low, and I'm just going to let it simmer for about 5 to 10 minutes, and then we'll come back and finish off the bubble and squeak. Like I say, to leave it for 5 to 10 minutes, always, you've still got to keep an eye on it. You don't want to get distracted and walk away, because that's when it's going to burn. So just keep it nice and low. Come back every minute or so. Have a coffee. Check your email. Have a cigarette if you smoke. Have a bong if you want to get the munchies. Not that I smoke it. I won't admit to it, and I won't admit not to smoking it. I forget I did live in Amsterdam for 2 years. Alright, guys, it's about 5 to 10 minutes later. We're just going to chuck in this cheese. You've got more cheese, but I'm not too fussy. This will do. This is just leftover cheese, little tiny bits, and so that's just about ready, but what I'm going to do is actually, I've just put the oven on at about 150 degrees. You don't have to do that. That's more or less ready now. But what I'm going to do is, like I say, put it in the oven for about 15 to 20 minutes. I'm going to put this in the oven right now. Like I say, these stoves, these cast iron stoves, are absolutely perfect for cooking any type of dish in the oven. Curries, pasta dishes, lasagnas, you can cook anything in these. When I was with Polly, my last girlfriend, she actually taught me about using these for cooking, and she's an absolutely beautiful cook. And yeah, like I say, even pizza, anything, cakes, scones, you name it, guys, you can put anything in those. Oh, okay, here we go. Look at that, absolutely. Look at that, guys. Beautiful.